Hello and welcome to the fifth devlog of my Milkman game. In this episode, I go through how I made these background assets. The first thing I made was a graphic for the road. Essentially, I just used colors I thought looked fairly realistic and created a grainy, dirty effect with the spray function. It took a bit of time, but it was lots of fun. I'm aware these are probably more sophisticated tools out there, but I'm familiar with paint and I thought it was relatively easy. I then painted the road surface with this texture, but had to learn how to apply the texture to the object in specific size tiles so that it didn't stretch in a weird way. I also realized that the double yellow line in the middle of the road didn't make much sense, so went back and changed this. It was pretty fun just driving around. I then started to create terraced house models, which are meant to contain the root of the milk truck by acting as a wall on either side of the road. I applied the skills I learned from building the truck and created extrusions for three windows and a door. I didn't want everything to be two-dimensional. For the roof, I spent absolutely ages, hours, just messing around with the terracotta tiles. I wanted to make them as random and unique as possible so that once I copied and pasted the houses, it wouldn't look like the same house again and again. I started coloring them in with pretty warm colors initially, and started playing around with duplicating them and adding features like bay windows on the ground floor, and flipping the position of the doors and the windows. Again, this was all so that there was a bit more variety on the street. When I imported Unity, I allocated glass to the window areas, but realized one of the windows wouldn't become transparent. Unfortunately, it was an early mistake I made during the extrusion process of the windows, and I didn't think it was worth the time to fix it. If anything, I gave each house a slightly more unique look. Again, I tried to randomize the little houses by making them different and using random colors, including the roofs. You may have also noticed that I played around with a landscape function and created ground, basically, which added to the overall scenery so that it wasn't just a road which you fell off of. I thought it was best to populate this with a green carpet of grass. I also got rid of the fog and added some sunlight. I thought that this gave the environment a slightly more cheerful feel. Finally, you may recall I deliberately left a raised void in the trailer so that the bottles would stand higher and would fall out the trailer more easily. Well, I had to fill this void and so created a wooden crate. Secondly, I created the texture of wood using various shades of brown and wavy lines. I wasn't sure if this would work once reduced in size, but once I applied the texture, I thought it looked pretty good. Alright, that's enough for now. I still have a number of game objects to make, but less related to the scenery and more to do with the gameplay itself. In the next video, I focus back on the milk bottles aesthetics, and in particular create destructible milk bottles which splash milk out.